applications for big corporates and for mobile network operators. And the main benefit for our customers is that they get increased sales, they get the ability to be able to get my customer mind chain, understand what they're doing through this mobile application, get customer insight, which was mentioned as a very important aspect twice today, and lower the cost of service, as I gave you in the elections example. Those are the really big focus areas of why we build mobile applications. And if you think, everybody talks about the mobile cloud, and when we started, the term was application service provider, then we became a commerce service provider, then we became a SaaS provider, software as a service provider, and now everybody talks about the cloud. And what is the cloud is all about, if you think from a mobile perspective, the best way to explain cloud is that the voicemail message is not actually on your phone, right? When you dial voicemail, your message is held somewhere in the cloud and you access it from your phone. That's the best way to explain it. Mobile phones don't have big processing power. They don't have a lot of memory at the moment. It's increasing all the time. They are becoming like mini computers, but those need to be more expensive. So if you can build internet-based applications that are hosted in the cloud and people can access from their phone and still give them a very rich customer experience, this is a wonderful opportunity for any kind of company to be able to exploit that trend. And we see a huge opportunity for storage, for music. For a lot of people, the mobile device in Africa is a multi-purpose device. It's their wallet, it's their iPod, it is their key to their door sometimes, depends where you are in Africa. Okay. Now we've got business cards that are being held on the device, digital cards that are being held with QR codes. There's a lot of different promotions. So it's very important to be able to store your music and your videos all in the cloud and be able to access them whenever you want. And we see also a big opportunity for unified communications in the cloud. And a lot of small, medium enterprises are engaging where the mobile handset accesses information that resides in the cloud and that they can access it. So they don't need to have an on-premise PBX, for example. They can have everything directly in their mobile because of the poor fixed line infrastructure that we mentioned earlier. So at the end of the day, applications will determine winners. Let's try that again. So one of the things we definitely need in South Africa, and those of you that are from South Africa, I tell you, will agree with me, is a crime deterrent. Because the other day, I think the organizers asked me if I need security, and she said to her, and I wrote, I feel very safe. I come from Johannesburg. So crime is a huge issue in Johannesburg where I live, and we definitely need crime deterrents. But the point of this particular video is that applications are what driving the smartphones and the devices. So when the youth walk into a retail store, from Safaricom or Orange or any of the local operators, they don't ask for a phone that does XHTML and WAP and Java. They ask for a phone that can do Facebook, that can do Twitter, and can allow them to get their email. And those are the applications that are driving this whole mobile application ecosystem and this whole excitement around where mobile applications can actually go. And applications will definitely determine the winners in the space. So there's a lot of choice in terms of development. I don't know if any of you heard about WAC. It's not a whole bunch of bad guys. That stands for Wholesale Application Community. And that is the operator's API that they've designed. It's actually a team between Vodafone, China, Telecom, and SoftBank initially, but today Orange is part of WAC. And a lot of different operators around the world are participating in WAC. And it's to make the life of the developer easier to have a standardized SDK that you can build applications and be able to upload them onto all the operators' app stores. So imagine the opportunity for people in Africa to be able to build an application here that's got global appeal. We spoke about, you know, acting local and thinking global, okay? You build an application for the local market, but it's also got a global appeal.